Dan nung malamig ka ilan dito.
Or the value to it, it's
Suaranya belum masuk, Mr. Satria.
Check.
Yeah, we can hear you right now.
Good morning, everyone. So in this first session, actually our agenda is only discuss about the task that we gave to you yesterday. If you remember, the task is to collect hotel data in your area. Also in this session we will discuss if there are any problem that you found when you running the syntax to collect the hotel data yesterday. But let me share the screen. But after I look at the Google Drive that I have shared to you before, there are no hotel data that has been collected from the participant, but it's okay. We can still continue this session to calculate the room occupancy rate in the next session with Mrs. Nancy using the CMRAP hotel data that we collected yesterday in the folder scraping result. So maybe in the first session, I'll just try to repractice or rerun our syntax to collect hotel data in CMRAP for today's data. Maybe you can also try to run the syntax with me, follow me to run the syntax. Or if you have any question about the syntax or you have a problem when you run the syntax, you can also ask me or Mr. Anu, so we can discuss about the problem. So now let me rerun the syntax to collect the hotel data in CMRAP for today's data. I'll show you again. To run the syntax, first you will go to collab. Same as yesterday, you click the first website here. And then if you already upload the Hotel Info Collector file in Google Drive that we have sent to you before, you can upload it in this section. Or if you already upload yesterday the file or the syntax, you can just click the syntax. And this is the syntax that we use to collect hotel data from hotel directory that Mr. Ranu collected yesterday. You can also follow me to run this syntax again like yesterday. First, in the first comment, if you remember, this is the comment to install the package that we need to running this syntax. We can just click run on the left side of the cell. After this cell is successfully running, we can move to the next cell. Next cell is to import required package. This is all packages that we use in this syntax to collect hotel data from Agoda. There are pandas package, JSON package, fake user agent package that we have installed before, request package, and etc. You can also just click run on this cell to import the required packages. After that, you can move to the next cell. This is cell to create a connection between Google Collab and Google Drive. So if you remember, the cell is to allow Google Collab to access your Google Drive. If we run the cell, it will appear new window, verification window. You can just allow in here, allow button. And if the cell is successfully running, you can see at this pane on the files button, you can click it and you can see that your Google Drive file and folder will appear in a Google Collab website. Next is the cell to open or to access the file that containing a list of hotel ID, or the cell is the command to open hotel directory that we have collect yesterday. In this case, we use CMRAP hotel that listed in Agoda that Mr. Ranu collected yesterday. Same, we can just run this cell. The first cell is the first cell is to read the file. The second row is to cleaning data to remove missing value, and the last cell is to count the number of hotel in CMRAP that successfully listed in hotel directory. The output is like this. You can see on the screen. There are 933 hotels in CMRAP that successfully listed in hotel directory, and this is the data frame of CMRAP.csv that we have collected. If you remember, we will just using this column, this ID, to make it red for every hotel. We take only ID to make an API request for every hotel in here. Next is the function to parse JSON scraping data. If you remember, the yesterday we just see that there are a lot of variable in JSON data that resulting from Agoda API, but we only collect the necessary variable, only 19 variable here. Hotel ID, hotel URL, hotel name, hotel type, hotel star rating, hotel number of review, hotel image, hotel country variable, hotel city, hotel province, hotel postal code, hotel latitude, longitude, and the important variable is total rooms variable and available room variables in the hotel. And maybe for information is the hotel price. Next, we can also just run this cell to create a function to parse a JSON. And this is the main comment in this syntax is to start scraping for all hotel in data frame. So in this cell, we create an iteration for every hotel in hotel directory that we have opened before. And for every iteration, we will create an API request. Like yesterday, I have shown you how to create an API request. So the URL or the API URL parameters will change by hotel ID that we want to collect. And if we run this, it will running as the number of the hotel data in directory hotel. while waiting for this process to finish, maybe if you have any question, you can ask me or Mr. Anu, because we will wait this until this number become 933 item.
Satria?
Yes.
I have a question regarding the homework you assigned yesterday. The homework is asking to generate or get the hotel information in our location or our city. But please, I'm asking, based on this script, the hotel is already listed in the CSV. Is it correct for this script?
This you can for the script, the hotel directory is collected in one area. The hotel directory is collected by Mr. Ranu syntax. So the task actually have to run.
Oh yeah, from the previous one.
And continue with my syntax.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Now, we're still waiting until this process is finished. As you can see, for running 933 hotels, it takes more than 5 minutes to complete the sale. So maybe if you want to collect hotel data from one country, with maybe it can 1,000 of hotel in one country, that it will take more time. So you can explore more technique to create the faster iteration. You can use Scrapy or multi-thread package that I shared to you before yesterday. So this sale is complete. 933 item is collected. The next sale is to build data frame. So in this sale, we convert this 933 items to data frame and save the data frame into Google Drive that I shared to you. We save the data to hotel data collection folder and scraping result folder with the name of Hotel Cambodia, and the scrape date is today, 22 April 2022. We can run this cell, and if this cell is successfully running, you can check the hotel data collection folder in the scraping result folder. As you can see here, there are 10 hotel data in Siem Reap that we successfully collected from 13 April 2022 until today, 23 April 2022. So today, in the next session, we will try to calculate the room occupation rate from these two hotels data in Siem Reap with Mrs. Nancy. Maybe that's all from me in the first session. If you have any question, you can directly ask me or Mr. Anu. Thank you for attention. I give the floor back to Mr. Swag.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Satria. Before we move to our next presenter, please, if other colleagues have any question. Please feel free to share any of your question.
Yes, good morning.
Good morning.
Yesterday we have testing the coding, and we got some problem regarding to the running code. So kindly how to contact Mr. Satria or Nanu easily, like such as WhatsApp or Telegram, when we facing the running error code.
Maybe you can share the error, Mr. Santia.
Yesterday, it like Nanu running yesterday. It is not recognized the directory of the folder in Gmail. It is not recognized. Then when we running, it error the message like it doesn't recognize the directory in Gmail.
Okay. I think if you have any issue, you can drop email to as if you remember that we already have group of email related with the big data. Something you can drop there.
Yeah. In Telegram.
Yeah. There are any consists of ASEANSTAT, BPS, and also DOSM. And you can continue to use that email list, so we can deliver to the question to the right party. I will send the email so you can drop any question in email so we can respond to any question that related with the big data pilot project.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. If there is no more question, we can continue to the next presenter. Please, Ms. Nancy.
Yeah, thank you, Azeka. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Salam.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Nancy Fitria Deli from Director of Analysis and Development in Big Data Analysis Team in BPS Statistics Indonesia. Now I want to share my screen. Can you see my screen, Pak?
Yes, we can see your presentation.
Okay. In this session, I will explain about analyzing online booking platform data. From this data, we can generate several indicators. One of them is room occupancy rate or ROR. Now we will focus about calculating ROR using online booking platform data that we have scraped yesterday and today. In this session, we will discuss about an overview of ROR and how to calculate it based on concept and definition that used by GPS in our survey. And then the concept of calculating ROR from online booking platform data. Now, what is a room occupancy rate? Room occupancy rate is the ratio between the number of room nights used and the number of available room nights. The ROR value by BPS is calculated from the monthly accommodation service statistical survey, or PHTS, which is carried out every month in star-rated hotels in Indonesia. This value gives an idea of how many percent of the rooms available at the accommodation that are occupied by the guests staying at a certain time. If the ROR has a large value, it means that the hotels in that area are demanded by the visitors. This is the formula that used to calculate the ROR on the BPS survey. For example, a hotel has 50 rooms available, and among them, there are 30 rooms that are used. So the ROR for this hotel is 60%. Now, how to calculate the ROR in an area? For example, in an area, there are two hotels, Hotel A and Hotel B, where the Hotel A have 50 rooms available and among them 50 rooms that are used. And for Hotel B, there are 80 rooms available and among them 40 rooms that are used. If we calculate the ROR for each hotel, ROR for Hotel A is 60% and for Hotel B is 50%. So we want to know how much is the ROR value in this area. For BPS concept, we do not average this to value, but we sum up the number of rooms that are used and we sum up also the number of available rooms for each hotel. And we calculate the ROR from this value. So in this case, the ROR for this area is 43.85%. Now we will calculate the ROR for the data that we get from the online booking platform. We need these following variables to calculate ROR based on a BPS survey: the number of available rooms and the number of rooms that are used. All these variables available from the scraping results. Now we check the all variables that we get from the scraping result. There are about 20 variables such as URL, hotel ID, name, type, star rating, number of reviews, and others. As we check the data, related variables that are available from the scraping results are all available rooms that indicates the number of rooms that can be booked on the online booking platform. And the second variable is total rooms that indicates the total rooms in the accommodation. We don't have the number of rooms that are used. So how to use these two variables to calculate ROR? As I mentioned before, based on BPS concept, we need these two variables to calculate ROR. So we use this approach to calculate ROR based on scraping result variable. First, we approach the number of available rooms with a variable with total rooms. They use the same concept, which is the total rooms in the hotel that can be occupied by the guests. Second, the number of room used, we approach this variable with this calculated total room minus all available rooms. We assume that the number of rooms that can be booked on the online platform or all available rooms is the number of vacant room or unused room. So we can calculate the number of rooms that are used by these two variables. So that we use this formula to calculate ROR from online booking platform data. We use the formula that used by Adi Nugroho in 2020. The paper that mentioned yesterday by Mr. Rang. There are four steps that we will do to calculate ROR from online booking platform data. First, we have to merge all the daily CSV data into one data frame. As we know, the data collected every day, they are produced CSV value each day. So we have to merge all CSV value into one data frame before we calculate it. And then we check the data, is there any missing value or outliers in the data. After that, we calculate the room used to produce the ROR value. I think this is the end of the slide. Any questions before we next to the column? I think there are no questions right now, so we will proceed to the notebook that we will use to calculate the ROR. We will process the data using Python, and we will run it in the Google Colab notebook platform like Mas Ranu and Mas Satria used yesterday. The Colab notebook can be accessed in analysis folder in hotel data collection that I have shared to you before. And this is the notebook. Please note that before you open the Colab notebook, please duplicate it first into your own Google Drive folder. And then you can work on the duplicated folder so that there are no changes to the existing code. Here are the codes that we use to process the data. As mentioned before, there are several steps that we will do to produce the ROR value. First, we have to connect to Google Drive. This cell is used to connect notebook to your Google Drive account, same as before, this the notebook that are used by Mr. Rano and Mr. Satria. So just run this cell. Click connect to Google Drive and then choose the account that you want to connect and click allow. After this cell finish, you can proceed to the next cell. We load the required package. The Python package that we will use in this notebook or pandas to process the data, such as reading file, writing files, calculating, and many others. And then the glob package to facilitate the process of merging the data. We just run this cell, and then we process the data. Step one, we merge all CSV files. Please change this path word with the folder location where you store the scraping result data. And for this hands-on session, we will use the scraping result that have been collected by Mr. Satria before. The folder is in Hotel Data Collection. In scraping result folder, there are several CSV files that we have that we want to process. So just click three dots in the right side, copy path, and then paste it in this one. Run this cell. And then we have a data frame named merge CSV that they are the merge of all these files. Now we run this cell to get the shape of the merge CSV. And we find out that there are 9,442 rows and 20 columns. Step two, we have to check the data. First, we check the variable total rooms. This variable shows the total rooms in the hotel that can be occupied by the guests. So this variable should not be null or have zero value. Run this cell to check this variable. And then we know that some records that have zero value in total rooms variable, they are 856 rows. what should we do to this report? If you have the directory of hotels that contains the information about the total room for each hotel, you can replace the value total rooms, this total room value, with the data that you have. But in this case, we don't have any directory, so we will exclude this records in the process. The cell is used to exclude the this 856 row. Just run this. And then in our data frame, there are no zero values in total room variable. If we want to analyze ROR in accommodation level, run this cell to get ROR, to get the type of the accommodation. We want to know which accommodation that are collected. And now we get that hotel is about 4,000 and guest house type is 1,000, resort 800 and many others. Now we calculate the number of rooms of used and ROR for each record. Just on this cell. And then we get the, for example, the first record. Sevilla Hotel in 17 April in 22, the room used is 18 and the occupancy is 64.28. Now we calculate the ROR by city. The cell is used to calculate the ROR by city. As I mentioned before, to calculate the ROR by city, by an area, we sum up the total rooms and we sum up the number of rooms that used. After that, we calculate the occupancy rate by these two variables. Now we run this cell and we get the room occupancy rate aggregated by city. Now that we just have the data in Siemrap city, so the data that show it just one city. We know that in 13 April, the occupancy is 93.37 and yeah, about 90 and 80. Now in this cell, we save the result as CSV file. Same as before, we replace the path with the folder location that we want to save this result. In this case, I will save it in the result folder in analysis. We copy the path and paste it here and paste it here too. We run the code and now we check the Google Drive. Okay, this file has been saved in the Drive. The first file is the ROR by accommodation level, and the second file is the occupancy by city. Now, after we calculate the data, we can visualize it to get a better insight. So, same as before. In this cell, we want to save the image in the drive. I want to save it in the result folder too. I will copy the path and paste it here. And just run it. Run this. Okay. Yeah, I think there are about saving the file. So I just comment this line to show the graphic. Yeah, we get the graph of the daily occupancy rate by city. This is the our value in Siem Reap City by the data that collected by Mr. Satria yesterday and today. Looks like it's pretty high in the range of 90 until this 99.45. I want to ask Cambodia team, is it true that OR in this city is this high actually? In real condition, it is the value of occupancy rate in this city is this high? Any special event or something?
Mr. Nancy, do you intended to ask the question to Cambodia representative?
Yes. Yes.
Mr. Samtia, maybe you can have any comment regarding the result from our practice.
It is from the it is sorry from 2022. This is by month or by year?
Pardon me.
Sorry. This data is show by month or by year? My month, I think.
Daily.
Between the range from 13 April.
13 April till today.
But in the previous presentation by Satria, it showed from by year, I think, right? From the CSV file. So if you can show as a theory, as a trend, it is good. But this is by date, right? 13, 14.
Yes.
So if you can expand the duration by year or by month, that is more flexible and it means it's a long period of the data, I think.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, maybe at this time Cambodia doesn't have data. That's why I cannot confirm about that. But Mr. Samtia, Miss Nancy identified that the number or the occupancy rate is high, and maybe have a question whether during this period there is some event in Siem Reap.
Yes, because this April is Khmer New Year's period, that's why it is the most of the hotel is full. even I go there on 15 and 16, there is no room to stay.
Okay. So based on the information from Mr. Samtia that Nancy, that the result indicate something in line with the situation on the April, yeah.
Second. Yes, that is my new year.
Oh, I see. Okay.
One of the challenges that we face when calculating ROR using booking platform data in Indonesia is sometimes hotels that are no longer participate or collaborating with the platform, or hotels that are temporarily closed or permanently closed, the display in the platform show that the hotel was full on that day, but there is no variable or any flag to identification to differentiate whether the hotel is full or the hotel is temporarily closed or they are not participate in the platform anymore. So this condition makes the result in Indonesia, if we just use the result from the scraping, the ROR in Indonesia based on scraping result so high. So we have to make some adjustment to this hotel. I think based on information that Mr. Sampia tell before, I think this value is in line with the real condition in that city. I think that's all from me, Pak Seka. I give back to you. Thank you for your attention. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Okay, I give a chance to other colleagues to share any question that related with the presentation given by Ms. Nancy. Before other colleagues raise the question, I have a question regarding the last step in the script related to visualized data. That previously I just saw that the script also error, Ms. Nancy, but I missed the solution to resolve the error. Is it related with the component to be installed?
The error is, sorry, I will share the screen again. The error is in the line to save this image. It was work fine when I run it yesterday, but I think Satria, do you have any solution for this? Sat?
Errornya apa tadi ya, Mbak?
Cannot save the image in the drive.
Oh, it's
Kaleido.
Because Kaleido, it's maybe just a different version of Kaleido package. Kaleido is package that plotly package here to save the graph into PNG or picture format. So we have to use Kaleido. Maybe you can use Kaleido first version. Kemarin Kaleido berapa ya, Mbak? Yeah, it's the error is not because the syntax, but it's because the package version.
Yeah.
Maybe later we will find out what version that match with the syntax. We will give you an information later.
Thank you, Sandhya. But if you want to save this graph, you just can download, click this button, download plot as PNG, and the file is downloaded in your local drive in the computer. I think that's all, Pak Seka.
Okay. How about other college? Do you have any question? If no one give any question, maybe we can break or let me check. We only have one topic. The schedule for break is 10:45 in the initial schedule. I think we can continue to the next topic. It is web scraping for review site. Yeah, we can continue. For this topic, the presenter is Mr. Wahyu Calvin Franz. So I will give floor to Mr. Wahyu, please.
Okay, thank you. Can you hear my voice? Check, Mr. Sueka, can you hear my voice?
Yes, we can hear you clearly.
Wait a moment. Okay, let me share my presentation. Okay, can you see my screen now?
Yes, I can see.
Okay, good afternoon, everyone. It's an honor for me to have the opportunity to present our work. Let me introduce myself. My name is Wahyu Calvin from BPS Statistik Indonesia. In this talk, I would like to present about utilization of web scraping for review sites. In this session, I will not go into depth about the code, but rather the workflow. We can break this topic into three main sections as follow: overview, web scraping, and exploratory data analysis. For the first section, first, I would like to give you an overview of the data source and the data itself. In this topic, we use data from booking.com, specifically the review data given by guests who stay by using this platform. Booking.com is one of the world leading digital travel company. It enables property all over the world to reach a global audience. And based on the information listed on its website, this platform is available in 43 languages and over more than 28 million total report accommodation listing, including over 6.2 million listing alone of homes, apartment, and other unique place to stay. And if we look at the bottom picture at the bottom, and based on similar web, the booking.com website occupies the first position in the world rank for the travel and tourism category, and then followed by TripAdvisor, Airbnb, and so on. Okay. The following chart. The following chart provides an analogy for how the review data was generated. In addition, in this top, there are several times that can be assumed to be equivalent. At the right bottom, they are two risks. It can be assumed same as guys, and the review can be assumed same as recall. Okay. For the first time, guys must create an account, then fill the identity, find a suitable accommodation, make a reservation, make a payment, and after that they will stay for one or more nights. And after their stay, they will ask to fill out a review. However, if we look again at the following chart, there are two lines come out of the stay process here. One guest tried to end while the other fills the review first and goes to end. This is will certainly reduce the number of review that should be when compared to traditional survey. Maybe in my personal opinion, this can be compared to the respond rate, I think. But unfortunately, at this time, we still can't measure the respond rate itself. Okay, next. If previously we discussed where the data came from, now we will see where the data can be accessed. It appears on your screen, the appearance of booking.com website. When we access, for example, one of the available accommodation here is Plantation Urban Resort and Spa Hotel. It is in Phnom Penh region. And if we look at the upper right corner on the screen, in the red box, there is a guy's review menu from which we can get the data we need. And if we click this text, it will show us a review page. And this is the main data we need. Of course, this is just an example, so there must be many reviews shown. Here we can get many data attributes such as guest name, guest origin country, type of room use, what month of stay, how long, whether the guest is a solo traveler or a couple or etc. And when the review was given, and how the reaction was from the review given in text form. And the last attribute, of course, at the right of your screen, the review score given with a range from 1 until 10. Then here is the detail of the data source. In this presentation, we use the country of Cambodia as a case study with the region Phnom Penh, Siem Reap, and Kampot at the provincial level as shown on the screen. Sorry if my pronunciation and then the destination is not correct. Okay. The next is about web scraping. This section has been discussed in detail yesterday's session. In this case study, the data is collected by using web scraping technique, and the process is done by utilizing at the HTML structure of the website page. With this technique, we will extract information from its HTML structure. For example, we want to get the stay time attribute here in the left of the screen. Okay, I can zoom this slide. You can see on the left of your screen, here's the target that attribute we want, that is stay time on month, and we can look this tag at the console, and we inspect element. Sorry, I mean inspect element, and we see this April 2022 is located at span tag with class C review block that here in the left of your screen. Yes, oh, sorry, on the right of your screen. And by using this HTML, we can get the data for other attribute also. Okay. The web scraping tools we use are Python and all script written in Python programming language. And we use Google Colabs as a place or IDE to run the code online. So we can access it everywhere, anytime, with any device. And request and beautiful soup package, they are packages we need to extract information from HTML. Okay. The workflow of this scraping itself can be seen in the chart on your screen. First, we set up the region. The region we want to collect the data for. It can be countries, province, or any area level. For this study, we use a province that stated before. So after that, it visit the first rate for first page for each region and list all available accommodation. After that, it visit the review page and collect all review. And this is in the workflow, you can see there's a two loop. There are two loop. The first is see is the review. Is we get all the review, or there's another review in the next page. For your information, in this booking site, the accommodation list and the review list show is every issue is in 25 row or 25 record. So we have to do some looping to get all the record of review. And okay, maybe I can show a little bit about the code. Here is the, we can set up the region list. It we stated here in the code. Set up region list. We set up for country code Cambodia with country code KH. Then we set up the regions Phnom Penh, Siem Reap, Kampot. And after that, it will list all available accommodation room. It is here. Place all available room, find its accommodation profile, and it will, after that, collect the review here. Collect the review for each accommodation. Okay. Next, and for this case, we can see in the screen, as the result, the following is the amount of review data that was successfully retrieved. You can see in the screen, Phnom Penh get 225 properties or accommodation, Siem Reap 300, and Kampot 91 accommodation. And for the total of these three region, we got 28,100 review. And here's undercode. I just copied it into slide. And next, for your for your information, I last run this Craver a few days ago, so it can is a new data, I think. Okay, then let's we see what insight or pattern we can find in the review data that we have obtained. So here is the data set. We have 28,100 record or review. And if we break it down to the region, same as before, here. Sorry. Can you see my mouse pointer? Okay, I will continue. Okay, here's the result of the data we get. And if you see this data set is data we got from the review. And this is clean data. If we look back into the code here, the raw data set we got is from like this. The review time is still look like this, reviewed at blah, 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 and stay time like this, long stay like this. And after we do some cleaning process, we can convert these few attributes and it looks become like here, it become a dead in a dead form. And long stay also from string, it can become an integer. So we can make some calculation about this. So here's the clean data set. You can see also here some descriptives about this data. Long stay is average score in 2.5 night. Review score is about 8.3 score. And then we dip into analysis. For this visualization, I use Tableau software, so it will look more interactive. Here we see the number of review time by time. This is spreadly by year and quarter for that three region. We can see here from quarter two 2019 to quarter two 2022 now. The if we look here from key quarter one to quarter two 2020, I'm sorry. Maybe I think this is the time when the coronavirus I think affect for the ASEAN region. So we can see this review is decreasing very deep. Actually, for the if we look at the this blue chart is foreign tourists, so it's very affect the foreign tourists from previous quarter to quarter two. And while the review we get from quarter one for local tourists is decreasing almost 50% for quarter one to quarter two in 2020. Okay, next, we can also break the review number by the region itself. Sorry, there is an equation. Okay, let me continue. We can see the region for Kampot, Phnom Penh, and Siem Reap. We can look their share for the number of review here from 2019 to 2022. This is, I think this is can give us a view. It can be, I think it can be a proxy to view the condition actually for tourism in these three regions. What is happened, what is the growth, what is tourism. And next is about review time lag, is Mr. Setia Pramana said before at his presentation, if we use review time, we will get some time lag. Is normally, if we imagine ourselves go to a place, we stay at a hotel, and after that we ask for, after a stay, we ask for make a review, we are not directly fill the report, we can postpone it. And here's the for the total for the time lag. We can see at the column is stay time in month, and the in the left side is for the row is review time, is stay time and review time. For example, 83% guys who stay in January, they make their review in the same month, and the 19% in February they postpone in 1 month, 2.7% in March postpone for 2 months, and April. So here's the, we can see about the time lag, about stay time and review time. In big data, I think this will affect the velocity of the data. If we collect the data, for example, in May, we may think is for the May review is already all the data, but maybe some of review is not still filled, and also the previous month. But with this chart, we can make a view. We can now about the condition of the review itself. Okay, next. This is about the review by guest country. If we use the guest country origin, we can see for the total in the left side is dominate from local tourists from Cambodia, and followed by I think French, UK, German, and US. And if we break it down into year on the right side, we can see the change over the guys country year by year. And here's from 2021, we can see how deep the effect causes by COVID-19. the foreign tourists decrease deeply. And in 2022, we look at some growth here. And if we break it down to the tourist destination, I mean, where tourists go to a region, for example, here, Cambodia or local tourists, they are mostly, if we look at the thickness of this chart, they must go to Phnom Penh, after that to Siem Reap and Kampot. And for the French, so we can see here. And for Indonesia, I think they only go to Phnom Penh, is just one line except here. They not go to Siem Reap or Kampot. So with this chart, by using this data, we can see the this pattern where the country origin and where they go. Next, this is the top 5 hotel, the most review number for each region. In Kampot is the first place is Eden Eco Village, while the second place is Sabai and so on. For Phnom Penh is Wonders Hostel and so on. For Siem Reap, Koh Lan Hotel and so on. If we look here, for some hotel, I think almost all hotel dominate by foreign tourists. So I think this is give us a picture of the number of tourists who visit this accommodation. Next is about the room choice. This is a top 5 room choice for each region. I think the deluxe double room is dominate for each region. Deluxe at the second position and deluxe at the first position. We can see here what is type of room preferred by the tourists. Next, we can see here's I try to detail it into a table. The growth of guys by eight countries, we can see, for example, this origin, guest origin, Australia, quarter to quarter. And so the quarter to 2019, we get 69 review from tourists from Australia. It increasing in quarter 3 about 86% from 69 to 128. And if we see a whole table, we see at the quarter 2 2020, as I said before, I think this is the moment COVID-19 effect affect ASEAN. I think we can see almost all guys origin goes red from orange to red color. We can see here, and if we look at the 2020 quarter 2, 22 at quarter 2 on the right side, it's also since red from orange to red. This why? Because if this is still, this time is still April, so the quarter 2 is not yet complete. So this quarter 2 data in 2022 will grow up. I think this will not be read again. So here is the attribute of long stay. We can see the change of the average long stay night for local tourists and foreign tourists. This is maybe some proxy to do this attributes. And I also have example for Indonesia. We have compared it to the official statistic. If you see here, the black one and the gray one line, the black is official statistic by BPS. Sorry, this is the data in Bali province, Indonesia. The black line is official statistic released by BPS, and the gray is the data from booking.com, raw data from booking.com. So if we look, is the pattern is almost same. We can make it more accurate if we do some machine learning, I think. But for this chart, this is still raw data. Next, this is the average review score for change from each region. You can see here from Phnom Penh in this month's decrease a bit. And this is, you can see what the review score is. And I think this is the last. We can also make a visualization by the word of reactions written in the review from Phnom Penh. We see here what kind of word very commonly written in the review. We see here there's a bad word like poor. I think this poor word is in the three region. We can also see this pointing word in Kampot. I don't see any this pointing word in another location. And maybe this is can make also make us a picture about how satisfy the guys itself after they have stayed in the accommodation. And for the last, the challenge is we still have challenge in this data. How do we know the percentage of guests who filled out a review and didn't? If my analogy is maybe same as respond rate, as I said before, we still cannot know how to find it out. And then the second challenge is how do we calculate booking.com shares in tourism in a country or region? This is also so a big challenge for us, how to calculate its shares. And for future improvement, we can make some text analysis or NLP development. Not NLP is natural language processing, but the challenge is for doing a text analysis is it is will be very complex because it's very dependent on the language used. And if you look back at the review, it can be formed with various language, maybe in Cambodian language, English, maybe also in Indonesia. So this is very complex. And for further analysis apart from review data, in this presentation, we talk about review data. There is there are still also another data sets, hotel price, accommodation coordinate, POI or point of interest around the accommodation, accommodation type, etc. I think that's all for my presentation. I give it back to Mr. Sueka. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Wahyu, for the presentation. I give the floor to colleague that you want to raise any question.
Yes. Thank you, Mr. Wahyu, for the nice presentation and very interesting topic. We hope that we will can do all these things. But one more that I want to mention that if we can change the province. You hear me well, Mr. Wahyu? If we can change the province to the...
Yes.
You take the three provinces, Siem Reap, Kampot, and Phnom Penh. If we talk about Cambodia, we are saying five regions in Cambodia that is a different region that we can compare the data, such as if you take Siem Reap, let's say Hanuk, Mondol Kiri, Bat Nam Bong, and Phnom Penh. That is more different area in Cambodia. That means it cover all the popular tourists in Cambodia. And we hope we can hands on what you have shown us. And if you can show how to change, as I have mentioned, change the country, change the province from like a Kampot to Pasir Hanuk. Because Kampot and Pasir Hanuk, it is a coastal area, but the most popular is Pasir Hanuk. And currently that is fast developed by Chinese people. So they have a lot of tourists, they have a lot of hotel, casino, and they have a lot of foreigner tourists. You got my question?
Let me confirm the question. How to change the region? That's correct. How to change the region in the code? You can customize as you want. Let me share again my screen. Sorry, I have make it more customized. So if we can set up the region here in the code and the country code and the region code before we get this word, maybe we know this the province is Phnom Penh or something like that, but we have to make sure we the region spelling in the website itself. For example, I try to open booking.com. The challenge is we have to make it fit the keyword is have to fit with the keyword in the let's say region in the booking.com. Sorry, the internet is so slow. Here, for example, this is defaultly because I'm in Indonesia. It will show the. Wait a minute. It will suggest us the region in where it is popular, and if you want to know the word stated in this booking.com, we can type it. For example,
you try Pasir Hanuk.
Can you spell it on maybe on text, maybe on Zoom chat? Sorry for that. Okay. I copied from chat. So the first is correct.
Yeah.
So we have to, let's say this, you enter the, sorry if my pronunciation is wrong, Preya Sihanouk Phil, but in the booking.com, the keyword is Sihanouk Phil. So we use this word for the keyword and we copy it to this code, for example. Maybe we can try to run it. So wait a moment. Okay. Comment about this and change it. This will looping over the review page. I think we just use the first page to make it faster. Okay. The country code is, we also have to look it at the website. You can find it in the website here. Let me try first. You can look the code here in the, if we look the URL, the country code is KH for Indonesia. I think it's ID. You can see here for your each country here. Okay, already set. Now we run for Sihanouk Phil. Let me try. I think we just do it also for the first 25 accommodation, or it will took time so long. Okay, first 25 accommodation and first 25 review for each accommodation. Okay. You can run it with a moment. This takes time. I think everyone can use the code and customize my this code and just change the country code, set up the region. You can set up the regions more than three. You can customize it maybe 10 or 20 or other numbers. Just make it into list just like this. Okay, we got 61 accommodation, 61. Okay, that's correct. Accommodation found, and we got 439 review. This is only the first review. We 25 first review for 25 first accommodation. So this is not the all review. We got it. Now we got it and we can see the result here. Here the example of the raw data. Okay, accommodation name, Yongsun Hotel, Quinzo Hotel and Casino, Chan Boutique Hotel. Here's the guys and its country origin, Melanie from German and so on. And where when they stay, And when they review, make a review, April, January, January. How long they stay, one night, one night. This hint from Cambodia stay for 20 nights, and he give 7.5 score of review. We clean this data set. Here's the clean data set. Okay. This is same like the previous presentation. We save it into Colab, but for now we do it. Okay, we make a plot of the for the conclusion. You can customize the region by yourself for this code. I think that's my answer. Okay. Maybe I give it back to Mr. Sweka.
Mr. Bahu, thank you for your showing. But how about the virtualization? What is the coding behind? You got my question?
Yes. I share my screen again. I have already do some simple visualization. Here's also in my code, but for the visualization, if you want to make it form like this and on the slide, I use Tableau software. I just connect it into file here, a file that we have got, and I save it in the Google Drive. I just connect it and I visualize it, and it become like this. For the visualization, for the advanced visualization like this, not simple visualization, I use Tableau, and Tableau is not not need a code, just drag and drop. So I can maybe later share my Tableau project, so you have not to drag and drop to make a visualization anymore. Maybe that's it. Maybe that's my answer. Thank you.
Sorry to jump, Mr. Santia. For the Tableau and also Power BI, last year in our workshop last year, BPS Indonesia and our college from Department of Statistics Malaysia have shared dashboard tool for visualization. Maybe you can gather again about your college that joined the workshop last year, or maybe I can share the video that in the last year workshop. So maybe you can just visit and try to explore the tools. I'm not sure about the Tableau, but if you as an alternative, you can use Power BI, and the Power BI can consider as a free tool. You can play with the Power BI as alternative. I will share as well related with the data visualization. I will share the link from last year workshop, Mr. Santia.
Okay, yes, thank you, sir.
Okay. Any other question? Mr. Ridwan, maybe?
Okay, just a question on first I want to know that is it it's not on what Satria has done, but it's on overall that we have learned in these 2 days. So we have done web crawling on booking.com, and yesterday we do on Agoda, right? So does this has been used as official statistic in BPS? And since this is a web crawling concept, is there any do you have any as what we have discussed on MPD yesterday, on MPD data, we need to have some agreement with the owner of the data, let's say Booking or Agoda. So does this also you have an agreement with the owner of the data? That's the question. And then another one, just to mention that, did you share the Python script on booking reviews? Because our team don't have it. Just to ask that one. Thank you.
Okay. For the first question, is this big data, I think result has been being official statistic, is that correct? We have tried and still trying to make it official statistic, but for now, I think as Mrs. Al-Fatiha Retno said before, there are so many steps to do to make us confident about this big data. As I stated in the last presentation, we still have challenge how to calculate its share or how to or anything. So my answer is we still trying on it, but for now for Agoda and Booking, actually we still not make it a official statistic. And the second question, sorry,
do you have since now that you are crawling from Agoda and booking.com, so do you have any agreement with the ownership of the data, so the Booking and the Agoda, or you just crawl it without them knowing that we have crawled the data?
Okay, for maybe the answer is still same with the first answer, we still try on it, but for Agoda we try to contact the company here in Indonesia, but I don't know what is happen next because it's on the high level. I think it's on the high level business. But as I know, we still do contact. We try to contact them, make an such as MOU, but for Booking itself, the challenge is I think they have not have office region, maybe in Indonesia, I think. While Agoda already have office in Indonesia, this is also make it challenge for us. So for now we scrape the data from the website, and I think they don't know about it except they look at their log file in the server maybe. Maybe my other colleagues will add these answers, Satria or Nancy.
Yeah, because we also have the same issue here, because based on most of my readings on this kind of concept of web crawling, so we have to alert with the you know, each of the website have their own copyrights.
Yes,
so we have to alert on their copyrights and I think it is an international issue lah, because it has been also discussed in UNSD task team on big data for official statistics under the scanner data and web crawling data. So just to know how is the approach from the BPS, because we also have the same issue on this one lah. Even our data, our
I think we wait for a few moments. I think Mr. Ridwan get dropped from the Zoom. Maybe the connection issue. Mr. Wahyu, related with the script that you have shared, will you share the script?
Yes, maybe I will check with maybe for Zoom chat or another meeting.
Yeah, you can drop in the chat so all audience can copy this.
Wait a moment.
Okay. Thanks, Pak Sweka and Satya.
Mr. Ridwan.
Yeah.
I think our last speaker not Pak Setia, Mr. Wahyu.
Mr. Wahyu. Sorry. Thank you. My talk has just shut down. I think I have charged it, but the plug is not on.
Okay.
That's
no problem.
Having left. Yeah. Thanks.
Yeah. Okay, Mr. Wahyu have shared the link that related for the last script. Any other question from Mr. Ridwan?
No.
Okay, how about other colleague? So quiet. So if there is no more question, I think we can accomplish our workshop for today. Now 9:55, so we can complete all topic earlier than initially scheduled. Thank you to our colleagues from BPS Statistics Indonesia for sharing about big data on tourism for these 2 days. For Mr. Setia, Mr. Al-Fatiha, Ms. Al-Fatiha, Mr. Ranu, Ms. Nancy, and also Mr. Wahyu. Thank you for your presentation. All colleagues, don't forget that next week, on Monday and Tuesday, we will have presentation about big data on price statistics by our colleagues from Department of Statistics Malaysia. The beneficiary for price statistics is LSB, Law Statistics Bureau, and we also our colleagues from Philippine Statistic Authority. Okay. So I think we can complete our session for today. See you next week and have a nice weekend. See you. Thank you all.
Thank you, Mrs. Rekha.
Thank you.
Thank you. I'm recording.